greetings. The conversation continued with more great questions. My question is the existence of God to people who lived before Abraham. Were the people who lived before Abraham given prophets too? Also, since Jesus was the Son of God and existed always, did those people living before Abraham know this? Also, can you tell me why Jesus came to earth after Moses, but not before Moses? Good to hear from you, brother. You asked, my question is the existence of God to people who lived before Abraham. Did the people who lived before Abraham have prophets too? The Bible records the interaction from Adam and Eve through Abraham. For example, God walked in the garden with Adam and Eve. The Torah records the earliest interactions by God, and there are prophets mentioned in the Torah. This would include Enoch, Abraham, Isaac and Jacob, Joshua, and others. But we do not have records by them beyond what Moses was inspired to record. So they knew of Yahweh. In fact, Eve was the first to call God by his name Yahweh. Genesis 4:1, and Adam knew Eve his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain, and said, I have gotten a man from Yahweh, the Lord. So we know God did interact with men before Abraham. You asked, also, since Jesus was the Son of God and always existed, did those people living before Abraham know this? No one may know anything about God except what God reveals about himself. 1 Corinthians 2:11. For who among men knows the things of the man except the spirit of the man within him? So also, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God. We need the Spirit of God to reveal to us. John 16:13. But when he, the Spirit of truth, shall come, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak from himself, but whatever he may hear, he will speak, and he will declare to you the things coming. He will glorify me, and he will take from that which is mine, and will disclose it to you. Even the very name of God, Yahweh, was a mystery until God revealed it. Exodus 6:3, I appeared to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob as El Shaddai, God Almighty, but I did not reveal my name, Yahweh, to them. The Bible says that some things are revealed about God by his creations. Psalm 19:1, from the director of music, a psalm of David. The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hands. Romans 1:20, for since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, his eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly seen, being understood from what has been made, so that people are without excuse. You asked, also, can you tell me why Jesus came to earth after Moses, but not before Moses? There is some discussion whether Jesus appeared in the Old Testament. Genesis 18:1, now the Lord, Yahweh, appeared to him, Abraham, by the oaks of Mamre, while he was sitting at the tent door in the heat of the day. During this episode, Yahweh, the Lord, ate with Abraham, ate cakes that Sarah had prepared. It does not specifically say this is Jesus, but that is a possible and plausible meaning which is consistent with other scripture. This would have certainly been before Moses walked the earth. Secondly, Moses was a prophet who revealed Jesus would later come with a specific purpose, a promised visitation to Israel. Deuteronomy 18:15, the Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among you, from your countrymen. You shall listen to him. Deuteronomy 18:18, I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him. Jesus could not come before Moses for the reason that the prophets establish who Jesus is. But Jesus could make visitations before his real first appearance. For example, with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, three men thrown into the fiery furnace, and four men appear within. Daniel 3:25, he answered and said, Lo, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt, and the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. Later prophets supported and reinforced this revelation of a visitation from God. Malachi 3:1, Behold, I am going to send my messenger, and he will clear the way before me, and the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple, the messenger, meaning prophet, of the covenant in whom you delight. Behold, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. So God revealed that God would come to his temple, and when he came, the Lord would come as a prophet. I think that is one of the most staggering prophecies ever revealed. Now, when a Muslim brother tells me, we believe Jesus was a prophet, I want to grab their hands in mine and shout, yes, 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 yes. Almighty God said that when he came to visit his temple, he would come as a prophet, a messenger of the new covenant. Satan thinks he robs God of his glory, calling him only a prophet. But this really confirms what God said by prophet Malachi. And the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple, the messenger, meaning prophet, of the covenant. God's plan was revealed across time, over several thousand years, because only God exists outside time and can send such a message and fulfill it in every detail. That is the likely reason why Jesus came as the last messenger from God. All the previous prophets served the purpose of describing Jesus, so that when Jesus came, who he was would be irrefutable. God come in the flesh. When and where did the prophets say that God would come? Isaiah 43, the voice of him that cries in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Why make a highway or a straight path for God? Because he is going to come. News this important was confirmed. Malachi 3:1, Behold, I am going to send my messenger, and he will prepare the way before me. Look how clearly God has revealed and confirmed this, brother. Isaiah 40 verse 3, The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Malachi 3:1, Behold, I am going to send my messenger, and he will prepare the way before me. See how this phrase ties these together. Prepare ye the way of the Lord, and he will prepare the way before me. This is God talking in Malachi. And prophet Malachi says, Me, meaning me, God, Yahweh. The voice is another messenger, a prophet of God. Prophet John, to be specific. Because Yahweh God was coming to visit his temple. Beyond that, Jesus taught in a parable that God would send his Son last. Luke 20:9, Then he proceeded to tell the people this parable. A man planted a vineyard, rented it out to some tenants, and went away for a long time. In this parable, the owner of the vineyard represents God. At harvest time, he sent a servant to the tenants to collect his share of the fruit of the vineyard, but the tenants beat the servant and sent him away empty-handed. The servants represent messengers of the owner, prophets from God. So he sent another servant, but they beat him and humiliated him, sending him away empty-handed. Then he sent a third, but they wounded him and threw him out. God sent many prophets to the Jewish people over the years. "What shall I do?" asked the owner of the vineyard. "I will send my beloved son. Perhaps they will respect him." This story is also told in Mark 12:6. He had one more to send, a beloved son. He sent him last of all to them, saying, "They will respect my son." Notice the son would be sent last of all, because after the son, no other messenger would make sense. So Jesus taught by parable that he would be the last such messenger from God. So what about people before Moses? The Bible makes mention that Jesus did something interesting while he was in the grave. 1 Peter 3:18, "For Christ also suffered once for sins, the righteous for the unrighteous, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit." This seems to mean at the same time. At the same time as Jesus died in the flesh, his spirit was made alive, in which he also went and preached to the spirits in prison, who disobeyed long ago when God waited patiently in the days of Noah, while the ark was being built. In the ark, a few people, only 8 souls, were saved through water. This seems to refer to disobedient people from the time of Noah, which gets back to your original question of what happened to them. From this, I would gather they were kept in a prison or a holding cell of some kind, until this very time when they would have the chance to hear Messiah preach of God's salvation. One other verse in the New Testament also comes to mind, which I believe is related. Ephesians 4:8. "Therefore it says, when he ascended on high, he led a host of captives, and he gave gifts to men." Christ ascended when he rose from the dead. I believe the host of captives means these souls housed in prison, but now able to hear and receive God's salvation. When Jesus ascended from hell, I believe he brought those past souls with him. Thanks for a great question. Please ask any others you have, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.